Hi there, I'm Dan from Hello Game, and today we're going to show you how to reseat your RAM. First thing to do is to make sure you have unplugged everything from your computer. Find a nice flat surface to work on, and if you can, put down something soft to prevent your back panel from getting scratched. Once we have our PC nicely in place, we've got to remove the four screws from around the outer edge so we can remove the glass. Once we can remove the glass, we want to put it on a flat surface where it's safe, where it won't fall, slip, or potentially break. Once we get to the inside of our computer, we want to release the RAM. In order to do this, we press down on a clip on each side of the memory and push it outwards. When you push it outwards, you should hear a slight audible click and notice the memory will actually lift. We have one stick out. Now we do the next. And the second. Once both sticks are out, we replace them. When replacing your RAM, make sure that the notch in your RAM lines up with the notch on your motherboard. This is normally achieved by looking at the sticker on your RAM and facing it towards the CPU core, as the RAM will only go in one way. If you have two sticks of RAM, you want to make sure when you reinsert them, they go into channels E2 and B2. If you have four sticks of RAM, you want to make sure you populate every channel. Some motherboards may only have two slots for RAM, so adjust accordingly. On some motherboards, there is only one retention clip, normally at the top of the memory. Then push down one side at a time, slightly, trying to keep the pressure even as you push it down. You should hear an audible click once it goes back into position. If you don't hear an audible click and the RAM doesn't feel secure, remove it and try again. Once your RAM's clicked back in, you're ready to retest. Replace your glass panel. Replace your four screws. Now the PC is ready to go. Make sure when you plug everything back in that you're plugging your monitor in to your graphics card ports. If after this you're still having problems, please reach out to our friendly customer support and they'll be happy to help.